That would be the opportunity to present my research on the third International Summit, 2016, on the power of academic research for innovation in practice and policy. The topic of my paper is a model for measuring the impact of broadband internet on innovations at institutions of higher learning in Kenya. My name is Rajab Philip Mushiri. In summary, the aim of this study is to develop a model for measuring the impact of broadband on innovations at the institutions of higher learning in Kenya. Universities in Kenya are investing huge amounts of money on the provision of broadband internet. However, the extent to which this broadband is being utilized in the institution to spur innovations is not certain. The study, therefore, adopts a Porter's Diamond model to develop the model. A descriptive study is adapted for this particular research. Data was collected from existing records, from literature review, and through interviews. A 5-point Likert scale was designed and deployed to assess the characteristics and behavior of broadband consumer responses. Statistical methods were used to test the internal consistency, reliability, and construct validity of the study. The reliability and validity of the measures and measurement instruments were above the recommended level of 0.7 as an indicator of internal consistency. Analysis of the structural model showed that the model performed well and was adequate for the study. And since this was a pilot study and the amount of data used was small, a more comprehensive study that incorporates all the 67 universities in Kenya is recommended. So, what is the problem? Broadband is an important information and communication technology infrastructure that influences innovation and competitiveness. However, the measurability of this influence is less clear. Although Kenya continues to invest in broadband internet, the extent to which broadband is being utilized in institutions of higher learning in Kenya to spur development is not certain. A modified Porter's model is used to compare the determinants of innovation in the education sector. Technological innovation can therefore be considered as a functional relationship between five interactive determinants, which are namely consumer demand conditions, represented by CDC, advanced factor conditions, AFC, competitive conditions, CCO, comparative conditions, and policy regulatory conditions, IPA, at university level. This is the conceptual framework, shows the interaction between these determinants, AFC, CDC, CCO, and CON, and the intervening factors on the outside is IPO. So this is the modified Diamond model that is used for my conceptual framework. Conceptual framework is research. The methods that were used: data was collected from existing records, literature review, and through interviews. A 5-point Likert scale was designed and employed to assess the characteristics and behavior of broadband consumer responses. Statistical methods were used to test the internal consistency, reliability, and construct validity of the study variables. Porter's Diamond model is the analytical framework that has been adapted in this paper to study the innovative nature in the education sector. Results and discussions. The following hypotheses were drawn from this research. Hypothesis number one: advanced factor conditions have a positive influence on broadband internet use for technological innovations in the universities, you know. Hypothesis number two, income, education, and gender together influence technological innovation in the universities in Kenya. Hypothesis number three, collaboration conditions have a significant impact on broadband use for technological innovation institutions or higher learning. Hypothesis number four, consumer demand conditions influence broadband use for technological innovations institutions of higher learning. And hypothesis number five, competitive conditions have an impact on broadband use for technological innovations in universities. Finally, hypothesis number six, institutional policy on broadband usability versus technological innovations institutions of higher learning in Kenya. In order to examine influential factors of technological innovation, the study employs a regression model. The study first assesses the reliability and validity of the measures before using them in the research model. The research showed reliability measures above the recommended level of 0.7 as an indicator for adequate internal consistency. Convergent validity is adequate when constructs have an average variance extracted, AVE, of at least 0.5, or when items loading on their associated factors are above 0.5. I'm looking at the results and discussions. The constructs used in this study illustrated satisfactory convergent and discriminant validity. Both AFC and IPO together explain about 86% of the variance in technological innovation. Both paths had positive effect, having coefficients of 0.325 and 0.531 respectively. The two determinants had the greatest influence on technological innovation. CDC, COL, and CCO from conceptual framework had a coefficients of 0.053, 0.128, and 0.16 in that order, respectively. The references. These are my references. Reference number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the main references. Conclusion and future steps. Generally, this research was a pilot study and the amount of data used was small. This is attributed to the fact that the researcher had no official permit to collect data. Most of the data that was utilized in the study was collected from a sample of only four universities. A more comprehensive study, therefore, is recommended that incorporates all the 67 universities in Kenya. For consumer demand condition determinant measure, the study investigated only the basic user demands, broadband, internet for technological innovation. Further research could extend these uses. Universities should improve broadband internet infrastructure in order to increase its usability. Collaboration and external linkages with the universities are generally lacking. This is an area where more emphasis could be made to help universities improve their financial capacity to provide more services. In Kenya, the demand for higher education far outstrips the supply. There is little competition in higher education provision, which discourages innovation. The government should increase the number of universities and middle colleges to provide high education to consumers. Thank you, and that is the end of